Do you want to know how to put text onto some of your quilt projects? Well, then you definitely need to listen in to today's video because I'm going to be doing a book review that explains how to do that. If you're not already a subscriber to my YouTube channel, subscribe now and be sure to hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I have a new video. Hi, I'm Kim of Chatterbox Quilts. Today I'm taking a look at Text It, Quilts and Pillows with Something to Say by Sherry Noel, and it's from That Patchwork Place, which is an imprint of Martingale Publishing. Now, in this book, there are a variety of projects, mostly what I call home decor projects. There's a quilt or so in there, but there's pillows and wall hangs and things like that in it, and they all have text on it, okay, words on them. So the book itself has all these variety of projects, but it includes a pullout that has 7 different alphabets on it. So even though she's got projects in here, you could change up the text, the look of the text on it, by choosing a different alphabet that's included in the book. You could also change the words if you want, but I would probably stick with what she's shown you for the most part, unless you are a little more creative than I am sometimes. So the first one here I want to take a look at is the Be Happy quilt. Now, to me, this is just a smaller wall hang. It's 31.5 inches, so I would call it a wall hang. She calls it a mini quilt, but it's going to go on the wall, I think. So it says, I think I'll just be happy today. So it'll be there. So it's really cute. And again, she's got this particular alphabet that she's used, or this particular font. And if you want to change the look of it, you could just choose one of the other alphabets that are in the back of the book and use those instead. Then she comes to this called Infinity. So this is like a quilt, and this is great for a wedding gift, let's say, because she also has pillows that you could use. And in this, she has shown you how you can actually put the couple's name on it and the date of their marriage. So that would be a really nice gift for a wedding. And again, because you've got the alphabet, you can change to a different look if you wanted to. She also has this quilt. She spelled out freedom here, and she's using hexagons to do that. So again, if you wanted to change up another for another word, you can certainly do that. This is a 64.5 by 80.5 inch quilt, so definitely a bigger size project. But look at those big flying geese. They wouldn't take that long to make, would they? I like big blocks because they whip up really quickly. Another project here that's really cute is called Loving You Quilt. It says, and suddenly all the love songs were about you. And in this particular one, she is using wool as the applique fabric. And again, this is small. It is 18.5 inches by 28. So none of these small projects, I should say, none of them would take that long to make. And if you're doing wool applique, well, you don't even have to finish the edges. If you don't want to, you could just stitch them down on your machine. You could even glue them down if you wanted to, but you don't have to necessarily put a decorative stitch all the way around the outside of them. If you want to, you could just stitch in the middle of the letters. You could do that too, because they're not going to fray. Again, switching out the alphabet will make it look a little bit different. Choose a different font. Counting Sheep Quilt. Okay, this has got to be for babies, right? And you got the little sheep here made with circles, and you're counting. This is sheep number one. So I guess if you wanted to make a series of these, you could have sheep one, 2, 3, 4, you could have a whole different number of sheep. But this is what you're going to start with, and this is to get baby to sleep at night, right? Counting sheep. Really cute. And again, doesn't take too long to make. You've got these little circles. You could do those with fusible web if you wanted to, or you could do needle turn applique. Your choice. Then she has the home pillow, and she's using some bias binding to make that home on there. And there's some piecing, of course, with the houses, but really cute. Again, this would be a really nice gift for newlyweds. You could even personalize it by putting their names in the bottom, because you've got all those alphabets to choose from. Life is short, stay awake. I would say life is short, eat cake, or eat chocolate maybe in my case. But again, using the wool applique, and this is just a smaller quilt, 22.5 inches by 15.5, wouldn't take long to make at all. I think this would be super cute in a quilt studio or for a gift for one of your quilting or sewing friends. And you can have the little coffee cup or tea cup with a little bit of hand embroidery on the top there, as you can see. Then there's Hustle Every Day. That's good for those of us who are working all the time, or working online in my case. And again, you could change the font and make it totally different. A little bit of piecing on the bottom. None of these are going to take a lot of your time, because they're simple enough. Even if you're a beginner quilter or beginner applique person, you could learn how to do these and you could make them fairly quickly. It's not like it's going to take you hours and hours and hours. And a lot of these I can see making really nice gifts. And again, the pillows, if you didn't want to make as a pillow, you could certainly make them as wall hangings. They would be very appropriate for that as well. A sewing machine mat, I definitely need to make one of these. I do not have one of these, and they're so handy because you can put the various things in the front of pockets of it so that you could put your, you know, glasses in my case, let's say, or a rotary cutter or even other thread you want to use in that mat. So that would be really handy as well. She gives you information on the back here, how to do the various types of applique. She tells you how to do that bias binding we were talking about for the home on the one pillow. And then, of course, you have all the alphabets in the back here that you can trace. So a lot of opportunity for personalization with Textit, Quilts and Pillows with Something to Say by Sherry Knoll. So if you would like to try adding some words to some of your projects, you would find this a helpful book, or you're looking for a gift for someone else, you can probably find a project that would suit in this book as well. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to share it with your quilting friends. If you would like more quilt information, you can check out my private paid membership called The Quilter's Way. You can find it at thequiltersway.com.